हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल टू एवरीवन? रहमान माजिया शेफुल्ला पीर, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस
ऑल राइट, व्हाई आर यू नॉट सबमिटिंग असाइनमेंट्स माजिया रहमान? You get assignments after every class, right?
सर आई सबमिट
No, you submitted only till hyperbola, right? You have not submitted any assignments of permutation and combination.
No, sir, I have submitted.
All right, Nazia, what about you?
Sir, even I have submitted.
You have submitted. Okay, Peer. Today you will do. All right. I should be getting all the assignments today only. All right. So we are going to discuss about the assignment in the next class. Today you guys have to send all the assignments. All right. Of permutation and combinations. Is that clear? You missed only two. Yeah, it's been only four classes, right? If you miss two, then you missed 50%. So 50% of the chapter is gone. So don't miss the assignments. All right, assignments are made like tailored to each and every class, so that your concepts get very clear. All right. So do the assignments after every class. And Pete, why is your mic not working? I don't know. All right. Okay, let's start the chapter. We were doing permutation and combination. We started selections, right? So let's try another question today. Write down a question. In how many ways can a football team of 11 players be selected from 16 players? Try to solve this question. I'll give you 2 minutes. All right, so in the last class, we studied about nations, right? We have to select 11 players out of 16. Rehman, what will be the answer? Mazia, can you answer? No. 16C11. Absolutely right. All right. So we have to select 11 players out of 16, right? We want to choose 11 players. So you will using C here. 16 players, 11 players, right? 11 out of 16. This is the answer, right? So this is 16 factorial upon 16 minus 11 factorial into 11 factorial. Try to solve this, we'll get the answer. All right, next question. Is it clear to everyone? Majia, Peer, Shafullah. All right. Another question. The question paper has two parts. Part A and Part B. Each containing 10 questions. If a student has to choose eight questions from Part A and five from Part B, in how many ways can I choose the question? All right, try to solve this. The question paper has two parts, Part A and Part B. All right, each containing 10 questions. If a student has to choose 8 questions from Part A, 5 questions from Part B, how many ways can he choose the questions? Try to solve this one. Send the answers in the chat. Shafula, the question says, in how many ways can you choose the questions overall, right? There is only single question paper of two parts, A and B. So you have to tell me the combined answer.
Right? So I have to multiply it.
Yes, right. Multiplying it. So here we have two parts, part A and part B. 10 questions each. But I have to choose 8 from 10 questions and here 5 from 10 questions. So 10C, 8, here 10C, 5. And to get the final question paper, I have to multiply them because I have to choose 8 and 5 questions, right? So whenever you use and, you need to multiply. Fundamental principle of multiplication. This will be the final answer. Is it clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Right. Rahman, Mazia, Peer. Okay. Next question. In how many ways a committee of 5 members can be selected?
Sir, in the above question should be calculate.
Yes, yes. You have to simplify this, right? Till the number. All right. In the exam, you have to calculate. All right. In how many ways a committee of 5 members can be selected from 6 men and 5 women? Consisting of 3 men and 2 women. Let's try to solve this one. Okay, Shafullah. Rahman, do you have the answer yet? Mazia, Rahman, Peer. Okay, let's see. You have to select three men out of six men. So 6C, three, two men out of five women. So 5C, two. And you have to choose a committee for five members. So you need to multiply, right? You need to select three men and two women. So multiply. This will be the final answer. You can simplify this. All right. Next question. Everyone here knows about cards. How many suits are there in colors? Because you will be needing that knowledge here. Rahman, Mazia, Shafullah, Peer played about cards. All right. What is the number of ways of choosing four cards from a pack of 52 playing cards? In how many ways four cards are of the same suit four cards belong to four different suits four cards are face cards two are red cards and two are black cards. Cards are of the same color. Right. This is a long question, but very easy. Try each part. Send the answers in the chat. All right.
So what's after from a second line?
Second line. From a pack of 52 playing cards. All right. You have a pack of cards. You have to choose four cards. These are the conditions. First part is four cards should be of the same suit. Second part says four different suits. And so on. All right. You have to solve each part individually. Shafula, have you solved the answer?
I'm in third one, sir.
All right. I'll give you more minutes. Solved, Shafullah.
Yes, I'm sending you right now.
Okay. Rahman suits are, see, in 52 cards, we have 4 suits. Right. Hearts. Spades. Clubs, diamond. All right, these two are red in color, these two are black. All right, so we have 4 suits equally divided, so 13 cards for each suit. All right, Rahman. Okay, let's look at the answers. The first part, it says 4 cards are of the same suit, so it can be from this or this or this. Okay, so we have to choose 4 cards out of 13, so 13c4, but it can be from this suit also, so plus 13c4, right? This or this or this, like this. So 4 times 13c4. This is the answer. Shafullah, you chose 52C13. in the first part. That is the wrong answer, right? We do not have to choose 13 cards. We only need 4 cards. But they should be of the same sort. So you can choose 4 out of 13 like this, or this, or this, or this. So 13C4, 13C4, 13C4 like this. Clear, Shafullah?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the second part, 4 cards belong to 4 different suits. So we have to choose one from each suit. So 13C1 into 13C1. Why? We have to choose one and from this, and from this, and from this. So using and, so multiplying. Alright, in the third part, 4 cards are face cards. So Shafullah, how many face cards are there?
12.
Absolutely right. So you need 4 cards out of 12. So 12C4. This is the third part. In the fourth part, 2 are red cards and 2 are black cards. So you have to choose 2 from red. Okay, Rahman, face cards you need. All right, I'll explain after this. All right. So fourth part, 2 are red cards, 2 are black cards. So we have 26 number of red cards. So 26C2 and black cards, 26C2. This is the answer. In the fifth part, cards are of the same color. So it can be either red or black. So 26C4 or 26C4. All right. This is the answer to all the parts. Now face cards, Rahman. See, we had 4 suits, 13 cards each, and each 13 cards start with A, that is number 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then comes J, Q, and K. These are called face cards. Alright, so 3 cards in each suit, so 12 in total. Clear, Rahman? Alright, so next question. Yes, write down the answers. Done. Let's try next question. In how many ways can a cricket lesson sorry, cricket team of 11 players be chosen out of a batch of 15 players if there is no restriction on the selection a particular player is always chosen a particular player is never chosen. Let's try to solve this one. Solve this one, Saifullah. Rahman, Mazia. Alvia, are you solving this question?
Yes, sir.
All right. Shafullah, are you done? No. Okay. Let's solve it. The question says you have to select 11 pairs out of 15 pairs. The first part is very simple. There is no restriction. So you have to choose 11 out of 15. So 15C, 11. In the second part, it says a particular player is always chosen, right? So you have to choose one player. So one is there already. Now you have to choose 10 players because one is already done out of 14 players. So 14C, 10. In the third part, a particular player is never chosen. So we don't want one player, one particular one. So out of 14 players, we have to choose 11 players. So 14C, 11. This is the answer. All right. I hope everyone is clear about this. Let's solve another question. Committee of 12 is to be formed. From 9 women and 8 men. In how many ways this can be done? If at least 5 women have to be included in a committee. Right. At least 5 women means there will be cases where you choose 5 women. In the second case, you take 6, then 7, then 8, then 9. Because maximum can be 9 women, but least has to be 5. So there will be 5 cases. You have to solve each case individually. All right. Try to solve this. Shafola, solve this question.
No, sir.
Are you solving it?
Yes, I'm trying.
All right. I'll give you 2 more minutes. All right, let's see. So in the question, they are saying you have to choose a committee for 12 people where at least 5 women should be there, right? So whenever you face a question where they say about like at least 5 people or at least 6 people like that, you have to make cases, all right? So at least 5 women, that means either can be 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9. Right, because maximum we have 9 women. So let's see the first case where I'm taking 5 women. So 5 women out of 9. So 9C5. We have to choose a 12-member committee. So how many remain? 7. So 7 men out of 8. 8C7. This is the first part. First case. In the second case, we have to choose 6 women, so 9C6 into 8C6. Here, 7 women, 9C7, and 5 men, 8C5. In the fourth part, 8 women, so 9C8, and we have to choose 4 men, 8C4. In the fifth part, we need to choose 9 women, so 9C9, and 3 men, 8C3. Adding all of this, you will have your answer, right? Because it can be either this, or this, or this, or this, or this. So we have to add all the cases. Is it clear, Rahman, Shafullah, Mazia?
Yes, sir.
All right. Alvia? Okay, I hope it is clear to everyone. The next question.
1 minute, sir.
All right, note it down.
So should we multiply and answer in numbers, or we can keep it like this?
No, you need to answer in numbers. All right, in examination we have to simplify and answer in numbers. All right.
Okay.
Yeah. What is the next question? If there are 12 persons in a party, and if each of them shake hands with each other, how many handshakes happen in the party? Very easy question. Try to solve this. There are 12 persons in the party, and each of them shake hands with each other. So how many handshakes are there in total? Well, let's see. In this question, whenever 2 persons meet, there will be a handshake, right? So 2 persons produce 1 handshake. So if I have to count how many handshakes are there I can count how many pairs are possible, right? Different pairs of two. So 12, see, two pairs are possible. I have to choose any two out of 12. And this will be the number of handshakes in the party. Is it clear?
Yes.
All right. Note it down and we'll solve another question. Ten C two, so 10 × 9 upon 2, right? So 45. Raman, I think 45 is the answer. All right, not 66. Next question. In how many ways?
Sir, can you explain how you get 45?
Right, see. Sorry, this is not 45. I wrote this is 10, right? This is 12. Sorry, my bad. 3, 2, 6, 66. Absolutely right. I actually looked at like this 10. This is wrong. 66 is the answer. Absolutely right. Right. Okay, next question. Yeah, 66 is the answer, not 45. Well, this is not 10, this is 12. Right, next question. In how many ways can a team of 4 boys and 4 girls be selected out of 6 boys and 5 girls if a particular boy and a particular girl refuse to work together? All right, try to solve this.
So are there two teams or whole one team?
One team. We're talking about one team, four boys and four girls.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. All right, let's see. See, in this question, one particular girl and one particular boy refused to work together, right? So we have six boys, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, and five girls. G1, G2, G3, 4, G5. Suppose B1 and G1 don't want to work together. All right. So, no matter how the team is formed, there can only be three cases possible. One, where B1 is working. One, where G1 is working. Third one is where both are not working. Is it clear? Shafulla?
Sir, in the question itself, it says both are not working with the team. So it should be only third case.
No. They are saying refuse to work together. They don't want to work together. Like B1 and G1 don't want to be together in this team. They can work with the team, but not with each other.
Okay.
All right. So three cases, either B1 is working or G1 is working or both are not working in the team. So three cases. In the first case, B1 is already there. So G1 cannot be there. And we have to choose four boys. One is already chosen. So out of five, we have to choose three. 5C3, and out of four girls, because we cannot choose G1, four girls, we have to choose four. In the second case, G1 is already there, so we cannot choose B1. So out of five boys, we have to choose four, 5C4, into. Out of four girls, we have to choose three, because G1 is already working, so 4C3. In the last case, they both are not working. So we have to choose four out of this five boys and four girls out of this four girls. 4C4. We have to add them because it can be either this one or this one or this one. So adding them all, you'll have the final answer. Is it clear? Shafullah, Rahman?
Yes, sir.
All right, note it down.
So 4C4 will be 0, right?
No. 4C4 is not 0. Okay, 0 factorial is 1. All right, 0 factorial is 1. Have you noted down? All right, next question. A box contains two white balls, three black balls, and four red balls. In how many ways can three balls be selected be drawn from the box if at least one black ball is to be included in the draw? Right. Here, think about the balls of the same color are different, are also distinct. All distinct objects. In this question also, it is talking about at least one black ball. So we have to make cases: one black ball, two black ball, or three black balls, right? Because maximum can be three, and we have to choose three balls also. And solve each the case individually. Then you will have the correct answer. Shafula, have you solved the question?
No, sir. 1 minute.
All right. Shafullah, are you done? Okay, look at the question. There is a box, two white balls, three black balls, and four red balls. You have to choose three, right? At least one black ball. So let's make cases. One black ball. Two black ball, three black ball, right? At least means this. So in the first case, you need one black ball, so 3C, one and two. The rest of two, you either want white or red. So 6C2, right? Two whites plus four reds, so six balls in total. You need two, so 6C2. In this case, 3C2 out of three black balls, you need two and two. One out of B6. So 6C1. In this, three black balls, you need 3C3. All right. You add all of them, and that will be the final answer. Rahman, is it clear? And Shafullah?
Yes, sir.
All right. There is another method to solve this. All right. Without making cases. What you do is, you select three balls out of every ball, right? Then you subtract all the cases where none of the black balls is selected. So you will get at least one black ball case. So how many ways can we choose three balls out of this? 2 plus 3, 5 plus 9. 9C3, you need three balls out of 9. Minus all the cases where no black balls is chosen. So 6, we have white and red balls. C, three balls. All the cases where only white or red ball is chosen. 6C3. If you subtract this with this, this will be the same answer here. All right, you can simplify and check. This is method 2. Clear? Shafullah, Rahman, and everyone?
Yes, sir.
All right, next question. Geometrical problems. Write down. they ask about geometrical problems. All right, method two in Rahman. See, they are asking about the cases where at least one black ball is there, right? So if I calculate all the number of ways where we can calculate where we choose three balls out of nine balls, we calculate in how many ways can we choose three balls out of these balls. So 9C3. In this, we have calculated every case possible of choosing three balls, right? In here, I am trying to calculate in how many ways can we choose three balls from only white and red balls. No black balls is chosen. So two whites plus four red, six balls. And we need three, so 63. If I subtract this from this, then what will I get? All the cases where at least one black ball is chosen, right? Rahman, is it clear? All right. Write down geometrical problems. Lines L1 and L2 are parallel to each other. Three points are taken on L1 and four points are taken on L2. How many new straight lines can be drawn passing through these points? Right, what they are saying is this is L1, this is L2. They are parallel. Three points are here and four points are here. They're asking how many new straight lines, like straight lines except this, can be drawn using these points. All right, try to solve this. You have to think a bit different to solve this question. But this is very easy. Let's think about the question where we calculated about the handshakes. This is similar type of problem. To get a line, you need two points. Think about it like that. All right. To get a straight line, you need two points and so on. Try to solve. Shefullah, any ideas how to solve this? Twelve. Absolutely right. So to get a straight line, we need one point from this, one point from this, right? So 3c1 into 4c1. Selecting one point from 3, here selecting one point from 4. Why multiplication? To get a straight line, we need both of these points. All right. So the answer is 12. Absolutely right. Shafala, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. Next question. How many diagonals are there in a hexagon? All right, try to solve this. Solve this one. Saifullah, Rahman, Alvia, Peer. 15. Oh, let's see. In a hexagon, there are 6 sides. To get a diagonal, we need to connect 2 points, right? So if I write 6C2, that means I'm choosing any 2 points from 6. But if I choose these 2 points, then I'm not getting a diagonal, but getting a side. So I have to subtract all the sides from this, and this will be the final answer. So 6 into 5 upon 2 minus 6. So 15 minus 6 is 9. Shafullah, I think you didn't subtract this 6, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Is it clear now?
Yes.
Yeah. Next question. Count the number of rectangles in a chessboard. All right, in a chessboard, count the number of rectangles. All right, there are nine lines like this, and nine this vertical lines. We all know about chessboard, right? 64 squares. So how a rectangle is formed? This is a rectangle, this is a rectangle, this is a rectangle. So you have to count all the rectangles in a chessboard. Right, how to solve this? Get ideas from this one. All right, ask yourself, how do I create a rectangle? Then you will have an answer. Raman, you don't need to know the length and breadth. All right. You just need to know that we have nine lines like this, like eight squares. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Like this. And same with this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. this is a square board, chessboard. So this is a rectangle, this is a rectangle, this is a rectangle. All of them are rectangles. All right. So how to solve this one? See, to create any rectangle, you need two horizontal lines and two vertical lines. Right, Rahman? If you have to create a rectangle, you need two horizontal lines and two vertical lines. So if I choose any two lines of this nine vertical lines and any two lines from this nine horizontal lines, then I'll have a rectangle. Is it clear, Rahman and Shaifullah, Alvia, Peer?
Yes, sir.
So we have to choose two lines out of nine vertical lines, so 9c2, and two lines out of nine horizontal lines, so 9c2, and multiply them, right? We need both of them to get a rectangle. So 9c2 into 9c2, this is the number of rectangles in a chessboard. Simplifying this, this is 9 into 8 upon 2 into 9 into 8 upon 2. So this is 4. So 36 square, this is the answer, and this is, and 1296, I guess. Check, all right. Is it clear, Shaifullah, Rahman, Alvia, Peer? Shaifullah, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
All right. So this is the final answer. All right. In the next class, we are going to solve some mixed problems from selection and permutation. All right. And tomorrow we are going to finish the chapter. So everyone be present and complete the assignments also. All right. See you in the next class. Take care. The last part, all right. See, Rahman, to get a rectangle, you need two horizontal lines and two vertical lines, right? So in a chessboard, we have nine vertical lines in total and nine horizontal lines also. If you take any two horizontal lines and any two vertical lines, they will give you one rectangle. So if you have to calculate the number of rectangles in a chessboard, you can count how many pairs of this horizontal and vertical lines are possible, because each pair of horizontal and vertical lines give us one rectangle. So I counted the number of ways to choose two vertical lines and two horizontal lines out of nine vertical and horizontal lines. Is it clear? All right. Note it down. All right. And see you in the next class. Take care, guys.